the problem is mine. I'm not sure about the role.
Can you hear? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay, super cool. What are we talking about? Money. Yeah.
Money. Let's do it.
Okay, do you have a podcast? Where are you? What's going on?
I just started my podcast. Like, I'm not sure. I'm just talking about random things. So what's your podcast about?
My podcast is about, I have two podcasts. One is called Chatterbox. That's where I talk with people like you about random bullshit. And the other is Business Coaching Masterclass, where I try to help people take the next step with their business. So
this is the bullshit talk we are talking about.
I don't know yet. You know, it's sometimes we can turn the bad into good, right? You know, sometimes we can.
Yeah, but the bullshit is even better sometimes. Maybe.
You know, so sometimes you need to let go, right? You know, so sometimes it's sometimes you need to complain, sometimes you need to moan, sometimes you need to rant, sometimes you need to get shit off your chest, right?
Yep, it is. It's always better. Bullshitting is always better. We'll start from bullshit, then we go to advanced levels. Okay.
Yeah. Well, I had this. In fact, no, it wasn't me. My parents had this cup in their kitchen, right? Okay. And written on the cup was, "If you can't dazzle people with brilliance, then baffle them with bullshit." Okay.
I totally. That's so good. Like, you can't imagine.
It's like if you blind people with brilliance, then just confuse them.
Confuse them, yeah. Just muzzle stuff. Just say bullshit, 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 bullshit. They'll believe you, right?
Well, some people will. I mean, some people don't have standards. Some people will believe anything. I mean, I can say,
if you tell them yesterday you were on Mars, they will believe you.
Absolutely. If I say I'm a Buddhist monk in Tibet, they'll be like, "Oh, that's cool."
But most people won't know what the hell is Mars is. Okay, so they'll believe you.
Most people have no idea. They don't even know they're on a planet, right?
I mean, we are on this flat thing, just flying.
People think the Earth is still flat, man. I mean,
that's crazy.
That's pretty insane. You know, I was watching that. You know, the Red Bull stratosphere thing where that guy went up into space and jumped back to Earth. You know what I'm talking about?
I know. The world record. Yes, I know.
Yeah. Well, I was watching that, and you can see like the Earth is right.
Yeah. You can see it, but I guess those were just effects. It wasn't real, basically.
Man, there was somebody posted on Facebook the other day that there's an international flat Earth conference.
For real?
For real, man. For real. There's an international flat Earth conference where people from all over the world get together to discuss how the Earth is flat.
Question, did you check how much was the price?
Sorry, can you say that again? Did I see what?
Did you check the price, the ticket price?
The ticket price? I kind of... You know, that would be fun to go, right? You could have a laugh. Right?
Maybe it was like $5, or maybe they were just handing it for free. I don't know. I'm not sure. But
there were articles written about it, because it was like 200 to 300 euro per ticket, right? It was a real convention, right?
200 to 300. Well, I can assure you there's a lot of ways to make money for them.
Listen to this. People were traveling from all over the world to go there, right? They were, and you know what they had to do to get there? They had to get on a plane and fly.
And
you look out the window of the plane, it's like you can see the Earth. So what the fuck?
No. The plane is. I totally agree with you, but like, we just figured out we need to make money. Like, this session is important. We just made, let's make a bullshit conference. I will just make money. This is actually fun.
People do that, don't they? I mean, there's a lot of things that are just bullshit. There's a lot of things that are just not real. Let me give you an example, right? Now, I have a lot of friends who are into alternative cultures. They like to try different things. And it's a fashion and a trend now to do yoga. Okay? Right. And I'm all into this. Okay, so you know, there's a history and a background, and there's Buddhism and Hinduism and all of these. Yeah, respect to all that. Absolutely, respect to all that. But all of these people just sitting in a room doing nothing together. You pay money to go and sit in a room with other people and do nothing.
Nothing at work. That basically your.
Oh, this is. Look, I'm all for, like, you know, get in touch with your spiritual side and, you know, try to meditate, get outside the body, and I respect all of that because.
Normal. Okay, I get it.
I respect it, but I'm just thinking that if I was manipulative and I was in control and I had an evil mindset and I had these dark ideas, I would be like, how can I get all these creative people to do nothing?
Make them do yoga.
That's what it would be. It would be like, yeah, I'll get all these people with great ideas and all these inspirations.
Nothing and pay me for it.
Yes,
that's some shit.
No, it gets worse because you have to buy the right clothes and you have to get your yoga mat and, you know, you have to do the special courses and you have to get your qualifications and your certificates.
You can't accept everyone. Just the creative that you take their time and their money for the complete bull. That's all you're going to take from your group.
I'm just saying that if I was a bad man, you know, that would seem
We are not saying yoga people are bad, but like that's just an example.
You know, it's the way that European culture has turned a spiritual activity into a leisure activity, right?
Yes, I completely believe that spiritual and all that is. Basically, a trend will pass by, and making a yoga probably gonna make us pretty rich. And that's what we're discussing right now.
Yeah, because you have to go to India to do the special courses, and you have to fly to get there, and then you've got to book yourself into these special retreats with these gurus, and the gurus are just kind of people who sit quietly
and open a yoga. Yeah, I totally agree. It's a waste of money.
Well, it's these people have their own way of doing things. I understand that. It's just that it seems to be. I like to see people being creative and getting out and doing things and having conversations and talking and learning and.
Which gym is a great place for that? For yoga, like you're just sitting there. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah, it's stretching.
You're just stretching. You can do that in the gym, right?
It's like a warm up. You never do.
Even the warm up is even better at the gym. I promise you that.
Yeah, it's like yoga is just like a warm up, but then you don't do anything. It's like you warm up and then you do nothing.
You do nothing for that energy.
Yeah, it's and then you warm up, you do nothing. And then you finish, and then you, what do you feel happy? You feel satisfied? You feel calm? You feel
yes, you feel satisfied. You spend money or nothing at all. You're satisfied.
You've got less money in your pocket, right? You've got less money in your pocket, you've got less time.
Some people enjoy that. Right? Some people just do it. I don't know.
Okay. Oh yeah. There's a sucker born every minute, right?
Yeah. There's a sucker every minute. Yep. I totally agree.
Oh my God, my God. The world is mad. The world is mad. There's so many things that people can try and do. And it just, I see, I've got friends who I think are just really nice people, right? Their hobby now is yoga. And I'm like, oh God, guys, you know, can you not just go on a bike or something?
Everything but yoga.
We don't need enough. Please, oh my God. Well, imagine if we did yoga. Nobody would talk to each other. Everybody would be sitting quietly at home. Nothing would happen.
You can't talk because it interrupts the spirit. Yeah, I mean,
there'd be nobody going for a beer with their friends, right? I mean, there'd be no sports events. There'd be...
I totally get it. But again, some people like Spain, guys. We cannot judge them, but some people like Spain.
Here's the thing. Once you spend money on something, you are invested in that thing, right?
Invested in sitting around.
You're invested in the idea, and nobody wants to say I made a bad. Nobody wants to say that. Nobody wants to put their hand up and make a mistake. So once you start to spend money on something, you don't have to believe it's the right thing.
Yes, probably. And you're going to hate it if someone tells you that's a bad thing. You're going to hate that person.
It's just an opinion. It's like you're entitled to an opinion, right? I mean, I can say I like this, I don't like that. That's what makes mine cool, right?
What makes life fun. Everyone has different.
Yeah, and it's like I don't want to be in a room with everyone who has the same opinion as me because it'd be so boring, right?
Yeah, disappointing. It's fun to discuss.
That's why I like the podcast idea and the anchor co-hosting system, because it's like I can meet people who have completely different opinions from me, and I can be like, oh wow, that's interesting. It's like I don't have to believe what you believe. I don't have to think what you think, but I'm like, I never thought about that before. That's kind of it.
Yeah, I just get your point of view.
Absolutely. And it's, it opens the mind, right? When you meet someone with a different perspective and a different opinion, you have to stay open. Right?
Yes, just like you said. Well, I didn't thought about that. Like, just the idea of you didn't think about that.
Everybody can connect and that everybody's got problems. Right? Everybody's got problems that they have to deal with in their life. Everyone's got some kind of bullshit that's going on, right?
I totally agree with you.
It's important to understand that then you're not alone, right? You're not alone when you know other people's problems.
Even if you have different problems, even in different place, it's fun to know, like,
absolutely. And everyone has a struggle every day, right? There's, you know, whether it's your family or your work, or there's something personal to you, or it's, I don't know, maybe your car broke down, or, you know, maybe your leg hurts. I don't know, whatever. And everybody's got problems.
You don't know your life story, but, like, it's fun, like, knowing the opposite opinion, like, even if he tells you you're a shit, you're a douchebag, I find it actually fun to know why they think that.
Yeah, don't take it personally, right? Because it's, you know, don't shoot the messenger, right? It's just the messenger.
I don't see the world in your view, I just see it in my view. Some of the things you have great are bullshit to me, and some things that are great that are bullshit to you.
Yeah, it's our experiences, right? It's what we learned, and it's what makes life beautiful, the variety and the differences. Hey, man, we're coming to the end of our conversation. Thank you very much.